वेलकम टू माय चैनल आरएलडी एकेडमी। दिस इज ट्यूटोरियल नंबर 1 ऑन ट्रांजिएंट रिस्पांस ऑफ आरएलसी सर्किट। हियर आई विल डिस्कस वन गेट प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक। सो आई हैव सिलेक्टेड वन प्रॉब्लम फ्रॉम गेट 2021 ईसीई। So look at this problem carefully. You have one source here and you have one capacitor, one inductor, both are present along with other circuit elements, and one switch is switched on from P to Q at t equal to 0. Okay, and for this circuit you need to find out this value dv dt at t equal to 0 plus. Okay, you can solve this problem by yourself if you have gone through my previous two lectures on this topic, lecture 1 and lecture 2 on transient analysis. So before watching my solution, I'll advise you to solve this problem by yourself. Right, so you may pause the video right now here. Okay, I think you have tried to solve it. Now I'll try to solve. Okay, let us see my approach. It is very simple one. Consider this problem. So this is the problem, right? So here we need to find out the derivative of vt at t equal to 0 plus, that instant, just after switching. Okay, so to get this one, we'll use that previous concept. I told you that capacitor voltage is continuous even after switching, and inductor current is continuous even after switching. Okay, so basic concept is VC t equal to 0 minus is continuous, VC t equal to 0 plus, and the IL at t equal to 0 minus, it should be continuous again, IL at t equal to 0 plus. Right, now I'll consider t equal to 0 minus instant. So at t equals to 0 minus, I want to reorder circuit, and you can notice that when t less than 0, the switch was connected to P position here. So this circuit was connected with this one, and this circuit was on for a long time. So if nothing is said, it is already said in the problem that circuit was connected for a long time. So by that time, this capacitor and inductor both will be in steady state level. So capacitor is fully charged, and also this inductor, the full current is flowing. Okay, so under that condition, I told you that capacitor, when it is under steady state, we can consider that we can replace the capacitor as open circuit. Okay, and inductor, this one I will consider as short circuit, because that logic I had given you. Here the equation is IC equals to C dVC dt, and here the reason is VL equals to L DIL dt. So in this case, the inductor current is constant in that steady state. So derivative of this one is 0. So VL is 0. So this one is becoming 0 volt, means short circuit. And here in capacitor, dvc dt is becoming 0, ic is 0, this ic is becoming 0, that means it's open circuit, that's how no current is flowing. So first we will do this thing, we replace capacitor by open circuit and we replace inductor by short circuit at that moment t equal to 0 minus. So we'll redraw the circuit. So this is your source, this is resistance, and this 5 ohm is connected here. Then switch P, it is connected, then 5 ohm. So Q part I will not draw. This capacitor is open circuit. This is open. And then this resistance and this inductor, I'll make it shorted. Okay, this is your 10 kilo ohm. So this is your 5 kilo ohm. Okay, this is your 20 kilo ohm. This is your 20 volt. Now here we need to find out these two. Vc t equal to 0 minus and IL t equal to 0 minus means this voltage and this current. Okay, so these two things we will try to find out, and this resistance is 5k again. So here this 20 kilo ohm resistance is connected across this 20 volt source, pure voltage source. So whatever the resistance it is, doesn't matter. This point to this point voltage source is 20. Okay, so if I want to find out some current and voltage in this branch, say it will not have any effect. We can ignore that one. We can remove this 20 kilo ohm resistance because this point to this point potential is always 20 volt. Okay, see, this 20 kilo ohm resistance will not have any effect on this open circuit voltage or this short circuit current. Right, so we can remove that one. So we can remove this one. Right, so this 20 volt source, and this is one single circuit, one closed path. So easily we can find out the current here. So this current, this IL, I'll call it, this current is IL, t equals to 0 minus, I'll call IL t equals to 0 minus, that value will be total supply voltage 20, total resistance is 5 kilo ohm, then again 5 kilo ohm and 10 kilo ohm. So that is your milliampere because it's kilo ohm. So this value 20 by 20, that is your 1 milliampere, means 10 to the power minus 3 ampere. So I have got this one. Next, this potential across the capacitor. So that is actually the potential across this 10 kilo ohm resistance. That's all, because this is short circuit. So this potential gap is nothing but potential across 10 kilo ohm. And current already you have got it, 1 milliampere. So potential will be I into R. So Vc at t equals to 0 minus will be the potential across 10 kilo ohm resistance. So this I, L, t equals to 0 minus this current multiplied by 10 kilo ohm. Okay, so this is IL is 1 milliampere and it is 10 kilo ohm, it's 10, so it is volt, 10 volt, right? So 10 volt is the potential across the capacitor and the inductor current is only 1 milliampere. We'll be using these two because it is a continuous one. Then we need to find out this one, dv dt at t equal to 0 plus. So now I'll move to this, that next condition. After switching, what will happen at t equal to 0 plus? Let us see. So already you have got that this Vc at t equals to 0 plus, it should be same as Vc t equals to 0 minus, and that value we have got the 10 volt. And IL t equals to 0 plus should be same as IL t equals to 0 minus, and that value I have got 1 milliampere. Right. Now I'll consider the case, this one, at t equals to 0 plus, just after switching. Okay. Now capacitor, what you can do? If I want to analyze at that moment, just after switching, so capacitor will retain that voltage. Okay. So what I can consider, this capacitor, I can replace by one voltage source. Whatever voltage was there, because it will retain this voltage. But remember, this is only for that moment. Okay, so this is replaced by this 10 volt source, because the capacitor voltage was 10 volt, so it will provide 10 volt here. So this is plus, this is minus. And inductor, whatever current was flowing, 1 milliampere, so in this direction it is the IL, so it should be replaced by one current source of that 1 milliampere. So you can notice that the capacitor, the current through the capacitor could be anything, like in voltage source. So that's how I replaced by only voltage source. And inductor, the voltage across inductor could be anything. That is the same thing as the voltage across current source would depend on other circuit element. It's not fixed. Okay, so now let us redraw the circuit for this moment. Okay, so what we'll do? So now it is connected to Q point. Connected to Q point, so this circuit is removed, is now isolated. So I'll consider only this side. This is short circuit, shorted, count. Okay, this 5 kilo ohm, then capacitor, this resistance, this inductor. Right, so this is your shorted path, then 5 ohm resistance. The capacitor I replace by one pure voltage source. And this resistance is there, 10 kilo ohm. And this inductor I can replace by one current source. So current source value is 1 milliampere. And this voltage source value is 10 volt. Right? And this resistance is 5 kilo ohm. So at this moment, we'll try to find out the current through this one, because this is your IC, remember. Okay, so I need to find out IC at t equals to 0 plus. What is this? Okay, now to find this one, what we'll do? So this voltage is 10 volt, so this current will be 10 by 5, and this side current is 1 ampere, because this is in series. So this 10 kilo ohm resistance will not have any effect, as it is a current source. So this current will be 1 milliampere. So this current is this one. So if I take KCL at this moment, then what will get? Apply KCL. So you see, it is 10 upon 5k, means that much milliampere, 10 to the power minus 3, plus 1 milliampere, that is 10 to the power minus 3, this is outgoing, both are outgoing, and this is also outgoing, plus IC at t equals to 0 plus, that should be equal to 0. So this is 2, so 2 plus 3, So what is you're getting? IC t equals to 0 plus will be minus 3 times 10 to the power minus 3. That much ampere. Okay. Now I can relate that. This IC equals to, what is this? This is your C dv dt. Okay. So that is at t equals to 0 plus. Then I can replace. So what is C? C value is 1 microfarad. Sorry, 1 millifarad it is given. So 1 into 10 to the power minus 3, it is C times dv dt at t equals to 0 plus. This value is minus 3. 10 to the power minus 3. Okay. So 10 to the minus 3 will cancel. So what you will get? So dv dt at t equals to 0 plus, its value is minus 3. And that unit will be volt per second. It's volt per second. Okay. So this is the simple solution. So your answer is C, minus 3 volt per second. Correct. So if you enjoyed this video, then you may subscribe my channel, and for subscription you can press the subscription button, and then don't forget to press this bell button, because then only you will get immediate notification for my future videos. So thanks for watching. I hope you are going to subscribe my channel if you have not yet subscribed it. Keep watching my channels. I'll be uploading lots of videos in this channel. Thank you.